Hello everyone, in today's session we are going to see how we can use MaxxERP software on cloud. So first we have to enter our web URL in the Google Chrome, and then we have to enter our username and password. After signing in, we can see a dashboard here which shows today's sales, purchases and income expenses, cash balance, bank balance. And if you want to see it weekly, we can just click on week, and if you want to see it monthly, we can just click on month, and if you want to see it yearly, we can just click on year, or even if you want to customize dates, we can just click on custom and enter our dates and then click on proceed. So if you want to add any task or assign a task to a user, you can just click on this menu and enter the task details, to whom it is has been assigned and what is the due date, and then we can just see. If it is an assigned to admin or salesperson or a purchaser, it will be shown in the dashboard itself, and then we can just close. So next is the favorite. This is a user wise, so the user can have any voucher as their favorite to easily access it. So if I'm going to purchase, so I can see my purchase, or I can even add my invoices here. So if I want to make any voucher favorite or not, I can just click on the star available here. So if I want, or if I don't want to make it favorite, I can just uncheck it, or if I want to make it favorite, then I can just add it. Next is the search. Here I can search any amount or any invoices related to any account person as well. So I can see all my invoices related to my customer, and if I click on this menu here, I can create and support ticket. And next, if I click on this setting here, I can enable any configurations, or I can even update my company's information by clicking on companies, and here I can add the details. And if I want to make this as full screen, I can just click on full screen. And if I click on this menu here, I can just go to the previous year or next year and even log out. Next, if I want to change any theme, I can just change here. If I go back to the dashboard, if I click on sales, funds or products, I can see a graph or analysis of voucher. If I click on a menu here, go to masters, accounts, customers, click on add new. I can create my new customers here, and the account group would be debtors, and I can add their addresses and additional information here, and this state would be necessary as per GST. If you click on key contacts, here you can enter their additional information. If I click on tax details, here I can enter their registration type and GST number. If I click on other details, here I can enter that credit days, credit limit, cash discount, special discount as well. And if I have, I can enter that bank details here, their bank name, account number. If I click on settings, if this customer is also your vendor or supplier, we can just tick on this option used for both sales and purchase. And if you want to make this customer inactive, you can just click on set inactive, or you want to stop the transaction of this customer, you can just click on stop transaction, and then we can just save. And if you go to menu, masters, accounts, vendors, in the vendors we can create our suppliers as well. Next is the general ledger. The accounts which doesn't comes under the customer and the vendors, we can mention it in the general ledger. For example, we can enter a bank name, expenses or capital accounts as well. So for example, I have a bank name here. Account group would be bank account, and state would be necessary as per GST. And then we can just save. We can also create an expenses account here. And the account group would be indirect expenses. And then we can just save. So if you go to menu, masters, accounts, account list, and refresh the page, so we can see all our vendors, customers and the general ledger here. And if I particularly want to see only my customers or debtors, you can just click on option here, account group, click on salary debtors, and then click on proceed. So you can see all our debtors here. Next, if we go to menu, inventory, products, here we can create new products. If you have any product code for this product, you can enter here, and the group, category. If you have any brand for this product, you can enter here. Enter the unit name, the decimals you want for this product. Next is the HSN code, GS percentage for this product. And if you have any image for this product, you can just click on select product image and you can add the images. Next is the purchase rate. So I can fix the purchase rate of the product here. Let's say it comes for near the landing cost. Sales rate also I can mention here. Discount percentage if I have. Any scheme percentages also there I can mention here. And maximum discount to be given on this product can be defined here. If I have any minimum sales rate for this product, I can mention here. I fix minimum quantity for this product, let's say 10, to avoid understocking, and I can fix the maximum quantity also to avoid overstocking. Next is the reorder quantity. As the quantity goes below the minimum quantity, we can reorder the quantities from the vendor. Quantities I would reorder. Here you have to mention the number of days it takes from the supplier to your destination to deliver the products. And if you have any preferred vendors, you can just enter here and you can even mark this product as inactive. Then we can save. Next, if you go to menu, masters, inventory, click on product list and refresh. We can see all our product list here. And next, if you go to menu, masters, salesperson, here we can define our salesperson as well. And click on add new. You can enter the name, the address details as well, and then we can just save. Next, if you go to menu, purchase, click on purchase. So here we can create a purchase. First is the invoice number. It will be according to the bill number of the supplier, and the invoice date would be according to the supplier's bill date, and invoice amount will be according to the supplier's bill amount. Here you have to enter the account name. We can see that account balance is here. If we click on this icon here, we can see the pending bills. And if we click on the icon here, we can see the information related to the account person, their opening balance, purchase summary, their closing balance, PDCs. And next we are going to enter the product. Next we are going to enter our product name. Enter the quantity. As we have mentioned the purchase rate and the landing cost in the product master itself, so it is directly fetching from that. If we want to change the purchase rate as well, we can just, and if I want to see any information related to this product, I can just click on the icon here and I can see the information related to the product. And then next we can just save the voucher. So it says that amount does not match according to the invoice amount. So if this pop-up comes, we can know that if there is any error or mistake while billing. So this can show us that some product has been missed or any amount is wrong. So it can maintain the 100% accuracy. Then we can save. Next, if you go to menu, inventory, reports, and click on stock summary and refresh, and click on closing stock summary group wise and refresh, we can see our products according to the group wise. And if we want to see it in detailed stock summary, we can just click here and refresh. You can see it in a detailed way where it will show our opening quantity, inward, outward, and closing quantity. Even if we double click on the product here, so here we can see a particular product in a detailed way where it shows their purchases and sales entry as well, and how much was the inward and how much was the outward and the closing amount. And next we'll make a sales entry. If you click on menu, sales, click on sale. Here we can enter our sales bill. So here we have to enter the account name. We can see that account balance is zero as well, and then we can enter the product quantity and the purchase sales rate. If you want to modify the rates as well, we can modify you. If there is any discount percentage, we can mention it here. And if you have any expenses on this bill, we can add it up here. And then we can just see. And if you want to take a print, we can just give yes to confirm you. So here we can see the preview of the bill. And if you want to just take a print, we can just click on print. Or if I want to send an email, we can just click on email. And if I want to send it through WhatsApp, we can just click on WhatsApp. Inventory, reports, stock summary. We can see all the products here. And if I want to select the date range, we can just select the date range here. Let's say I want to see the stock summary of only. We can select the date range here and click on proceed. So it will show in the closing summary, or even you can see the detailed stock summary. And if you just double click on here, we can see the purchase sales or detailed information about a particular product, its inward and outward quantity and the closing quantity as well. Next, if you go to menu, accounts, for receipt we can just click on receive money, and for make payments we can just click on make payments. So if we click on receive money and click on add new, so here I can make my receipt entries and I can choose cash or bank and then the account name. After selecting the account name, we can see the account balance is here, and here we have to mention the amount which you have received from that customer. And then we have to adjust it on which bill you have got this 20,000. Then after saving it, so here we can also enter the bank name, check number, and then we can just save. So this was the receipt entry. If we go to accounts, reports, ledger, and again click on ledger. And then here you have to type the account name. So we can see a ledger of a particular customer, their opening balances, their invoice and their payment details. Next, if we want to see our outstandings, we can just go to accounts, outstandings, and click on bills receivable and then refresh. So we can see our pending bills here from the bills customers. And similarly, if you want to see our vendors, we can just go to same accounts, outstanding, bills payable. So here we can see how much bills are pending for the vendors. And then if we click on menu and select analysis and click on top end reports, we can see our top 5 account wise customers. And if similarly, if we need any vendors, we can just click on purchase and refresh. So we can see our top 5 here. Next, if I want to see my daily activities, I can just go to menu and then click on daily activities, and then we can just refresh. Here we can see on 15th what was the trading, and if we select the date range, even you can see according to the date range. So next we are going to see how we can generate e-invoice and e-way bill from cloud. So we can go to sales, options, GST option, and if you want to generate e-invoice, you can just click on generate e-invoice by IRN. And if you want to generate e-way bill, we can click on generate e-way bill by IRN or direct or by JSON file. And if you want to print e-way bill, we can just click on print e-way bill. So next, if you want to see our GST forms and reports, we can just go to menu, accounts, reports, statutory and taxation, and we can click on GST forms and reports. So for mismatch entries, we can click on mismatch or exemptions. For sales, we can see a GSTR1. For purchases, we can see GSTR2. And for any calculation mismatch report or stat type report mismatch, we can just click on those. And if you want to see GSTR1, you can just refresh and see a GSTR1. And if you want to select the month or date range, you can just choose according to it. So that's it for today's session, guys. Thank you.